back with another video, and today we got another NFL predictions for you guys. This time week 11 will be on the horizon, and how are we at week 11 already? It's mid-November, it's almost late November. I don't understand. Last week I went a terrible 8-6, which usually that's my regular record I give every week. But this year I've been doing actually pretty good. But that'll bring my total season record up to 98-52. So not too bad overall. And just short of that 100 mark. And let's get into it. Starting with the teams on the bye. This week, we have four teams, as always, and you got the Falcons, the Saints, the Colts, and the Patriots. So, those are the teams on the bye, and let's waste little time, get into this Thursday night matchup. Am I finally going to watch a Thursday night game? Probably, because this game, you have the Cincinnati Bengals taking on the Baltimore Ravens. Last week, the Bengals take a tough L to the Houston Texans. Hate to see it. The Ravens take a tough L to the Cleveland Browns. So, should be interesting. This game is kind of who takes the reins of the AFC North for the rest of the season. 5-4 versus 7-3. And this division is stacked. The Bengals are at the bottom now that I think about it here, because I see the Steelers are at 6-3, the Browns are at 6-3 as well. And this division is stacked like crazy. And if the Bengals lose this, they're gonna be done. They're gonna be done for the season probably. You know, they're gonna be at the bottom of the division. But you never know, obviously. It should be interesting. I'm really excited for this game. I think it's going to be a heater on Thursday night. But just with how the Ravens have been playing all year compared to how the Bengals have been playing all year, I think I'm going to take the Ravens on this win. Lamar Jackson, he's an MVP favorite. You never know with Joe Shiesty and the Bengals. You know, they've been... This is kind of where at the spot of the season where they just come and they just win games left and right. But is that going to happen this year? We'll see. So with that reason, I am going to take the Ravens. Getting to the Sunday games, you have the Dallas Cowgirls taking on the Carolina Panthers. The Panthers have still only won one game. Yikes. And then the Cowboys last week. What did the Cowboys do last week? They got a huge win over the trash Giants. And Panthers, who'd they lose to last week? Honestly, is it relevant? Probably not. The Panthers might have had a bye. No, the Panthers didn't have a bye. I think this is a pretty easy take here. I'm gonna take the Cowboys. They're just a way, way better team. I'm waiting for a competitive team to come up on this Cowboys schedule, and it really hasn't happened. They kind of have a Mickey Mouse schedule, I'm not going to lie, but I'm still going to take the Cowgirls. You have the Pittsburgh Steelers taking on the Cleveland Browns. This should be a pretty interesting game. I mean, another AFC North battle here, both 6-3 teams. It should be a good one. Steelers obviously picking the win over my Packers last week, and the Browns getting the huge win over the Ravens. I really don't trust this Steelers offense. I really don't, and I really trust this Browns defense, although last week, but like it's the Ravens, so like who you gonna blame? Honestly, yeah, I'm gonna take the Browns. The Steelers just, I don't see them as this high-caliber team like everybody else sees them. And the Browns, you know, when Watson plays good like he did last week, I think if Watson plays good, they can win games. If that offense gets it into a rhythm with Jerome Ford at running back, I think they can get things going because that defense can rely on them heavy. So, give me the Browns. These two teams faced off earlier in the year, and I'm pretty sure the Steelers won. Maybe? No? Browns might have won. I don't remember. But give me the Browns here. You got the Cleveland. I almost said Cleveland again. You got the Chicago Bears taking on the Detroit Lions. Bears, they got the win on Thursday night last week. Oh, yeah, that's right. Against the Panthers. They suck, though. And then the Lions. What did the Lions do last week? I don't remember if I'm going to keep it a book with you. The Lions, they might have had a bye. Hold on. Give me a second. Give me a second. I don't think they did, though. No, they beat the Chargers in that wild shootout game. That game was nuts. Bananas. Ridiculous. This got to be the Lions here. I mean, they're just the way better team. Way better team. I mean, 7-2, 3-7. Who knows? It looks like Fields is going to start next week, but is that going to make a difference? I don't think so. I really don't. So, give me the Lions. Next up, you got the Los Angeles Chargers taking on my Green Bay Packers. Back to losing for the Green Bay Packers. Not shocking, really, at all. You know, it's not shocking. And obviously, the Chargers took the L to the Lions, like we just said. Oh, my God. The Chargers have been probably one of the most fraudulent teams this season. You know, they really haven't played well at all. Like, not one bit. Not even a little bit. But, you know, the Packers have also been pretty fraudulent. But we didn't play bad last week, you know? Our offense, it was kind of in a rhythm at points. We were going back and forth. Our offense started hot in the first half. Second half, rough. Usually, it's the other way around for us. But if our offense can get it going like we did in the first half last week and keep it that way, then we can, you know. We need to spread the ball throughout the quarters. You know, first half, you can get a little points, but second half is where you need to keep it and get even more points and lock it down, because by the second half, our defense is just tired of getting stops after stops after stops. So if we can do that, hopefully we can pick up the win. I don't see it happening, but obviously I'm going to go with my Green Bay Packers, because I always go with my Green Bay Packers, and I never don't go with my Green Bay Packers. So, sadly, give me my Green Bay Packers. Go, back, go, I guess. You got the Arizona Cardinals taking on the Houston Texans. Cardinals getting a huge win last week. Kyler Murray returning, throwing touchdowns, making plays, bibbidi-bobbidi-boo. And then the Texans, they got that big win over the Bengals. Bad voice crack there. Can they keep that success going? Honestly, I think they can. I mean, CJ Stroud is, you know, a little left, right, the dance, dude. Oh my God, he's so. CJ Stroud's been balling this season. It's unreal. And I didn't. That was the last thing I expected. Honestly, the last thing I expected, because preseason, he looked trash. And then obviously the whole IQ test or whatever, about everyone flaming him for that, about how stupid he is after the combine or whatever. But, I mean, ever since the freaking season started, he's been playing well. I mean, they're 5-4. The Texans have won 5 games, ladies and gentlemen. I mean, that was the last thing I really expected this season, because I think I had them winning. I might have had them exactly winning 5 games. I might have had them winning. No, I had them at like 2, 3, 4 wins around there. So last thing I expected. So with that being said, I know Kyler's back and I know he's been playing well. I really think the Cardinals could win this game, but I'm going to take the Texans. When was the last time I said the Texans on predictions? What, like 2020 when I first started this thing? Probably. Yeah, give me the Texans. Screw it. We ball. You got the Tennessee Titans taking on the Jacksonville Jaguars. Titans obviously took that tough L to the Bucks last week. And the Jags also took a tough L. Big tough L to the 49ers. But I think this week, in particular, no, the Titans, they just really haven't looked good one bitty bit. And I think they're going to bounce back in a big way this week. The Jaguars, by the way. And I think the Jags, Trevor Lawrence, get it going again. So, give me the Jags. Next up, you got the Las Vegas Raiders taking on... Oh, my God. The voice cracks today. Taking on the Miami Dolphins. Jesus Christ. The Raiders, they got a win on Sunday night. Cool little win there for them against the Jets. And then the Dolphins, they... What'd they do last week? They had a bye last week. That's right. That is correct. And I think with that bye week, the Raiders, they're 5-5, you know. They have their interim head coach, and they've been playing well ever since then. But it's the Dolphins, and I think the Dolphins with that bye week after taking an L are going to bounce back in a big way. So I'm going to take Tua, Tyreek, and the Dolphins. Mike McDaniel, the best coach in football. Yurt. You got the New Jersey Giants taking on the Washington Commanders. God, this is a tank bowl and a half. I mean, the Commanders haven't even really looked that bad. You know, Sam Wells leading the league in passing, by the way. Want to point that out there. How is Sam Howell leading the league in passing yards? I don't understand. You know, they played well. Their defense just can't hold up in big-time moments. You know, they traded everyone away besides Jonathan Allen. And, you know, Forbes gets strays all the time. And, oh, God, it's rough for them. But the Giants, not that much better, you know. They took the L last week to the Cowgirls, and they just... They're probably the worst team in football. I'm going to say it now. They suck. They're terrible. They're probably the worst team in the NFC, at least. I mean... You know, you at first I thought maybe it's the Cardinals, maybe it's the Bears, but no, the Giants, they suck. They're lucky to put up points every week. Like, it's rough. It was close with these two teams last time. I'm pretty sure the Giants ended up winning barely. But I don't think it's going to happen this time. So, gimme the Washington Commanders. You got the Tampa Bay Buccaneers taking on the San Francisco 49ers. The Bucs. Obviously picking the win over the Titans last week, and the 49ers getting the win over the Jags. This should be a fun game. This should be a fun little game, you know, Baker versus Purdy. Purdy hasn't been playing too hot, but that's besides the point. Should be an interesting game, you know. The 49ers, after the win last week, I think you can kind of say they're back. So, with that being said, give me the 49ers. They freaking balled out last week, and I think they're going to continue it into this week. Next up, you got the New Jersey Jets taking on the Buffalo Bills. The Jets taking a fat L on Sunday Night Football to the Raiders and the Bills. Oh, my God, the Bills taking a fat L the next night on Monday to the Denver Broncos. What the hell, dude? What is life? I just, you know, Stephon Diggs. Josh Allen. They sold my fantasy. But the Bills did fire Ken Dorsey after that game because that was the most pitiful game I freaking ever. How do you lose the Broncos? Like, y'all suck. They're 5-5. They're terrible. If they lose this game, they're going to be at near the bottom of the freaking AFC East with the Patriots. But I don't think they're going to lose this game. I think they're going to bounce back. You would think so. You would think so. So give me Josh Allen and the Buffalo Bills. Screw it. Next up, you got the Seattle Seahawks taking on the Los Angeles Rams. The Seahawks, what did they do? Oh, yeah, they got the win over the Commanders, and then the Rams had a bye last week, as far as I'm aware. These two teams are another team that already played earlier in the season at the start of the year. And the Rams, they shocked everyone when they got that win with Puka Nacua. Could they do that again? Honestly, Maybe. You never know. You really never know. If Stafford's healthy, then yes. Honestly, I think they could. But I think based on how the Seahawks have been playing recently and how the Rams have been playing recently, I think with that being said, I'm going to take the Seahawks. I think they're just the way better team at this part of the season. It's in LA, so you never know. But give me the Seahawks. On Sunday Night Football, you have the Minnesota Vikings taking on the Denver Broncos. Broncos country. Let's ride. Yeah, getting a big win last week. It's screwing my fantasy. Sorry. Mr. Unlimited. Russell Wilson coming through in the clutch. They're 4-5. Something I also thought I'd never say. And then the Vikings, they were freaking 0-4 now, or they were like 1-4, something around there. They're on a big time winning streak. Josh Dobbs, he's him. The freaking aerospace engineer, he's him. What are they putting on the, in that cup? I don't know, but I think whatever they're putting in it is gonna lead them to another victory in this game. I mean, the Broncos, they have big time luck on primetime, it seems, recently. And then the Vikings, they have big time freaking just terrible luck on primetime. But that's Kirk Cousins. That's just Kirk O'Thuggins. And this is Josh Dobbs. So give me the Minnesota Vikings, purple incarnations of Satan. And we finally get to the Monday night game. Oh my goodness, people. We got the Philadelphia Eagles taking on the Kansas City Chiefs. A Super Bowl 57. What was last year's Super Bowl? Yeah, 57, I think. Yes, 57. Positive. 57 rematch. Whoo. Both coming off of a bye. Kelce versus Kelce. Mahomes. Hurts. 8-1 versus 7-2. This game happened in the regular season last year. The Eagles freaking destroyed the Chiefs. And then came around the Super Bowl and the refs got involved big time. But we don't talk about it. And you know, this season it's been kind of a we're making the Chiefs win, we're making the Eagles win. This is refs versus refs. Who's going to win the ultimate ref game championship? We'll have to find out. But I'm basing this off the records. Am I taking them? Yeah. Screw it. Give me the Eagles. I haven't really seen a lot from the Chiefs this year that will, like, make, you know, the win over the Dolphins, I think, was really, really key. Although the Dolphins just sucked that day in general. But I think the Eagles have played way better this season. Obviously, I mean, they're one loss difference. But I think the Eagles, will definitely get another win here on Monday night. This should be, I mean, I don't even care if I get this game wrong, because this is better be game of the year. They better go out there, score freaking 100 points each. I don't even think that's possible, but that'd be cool. That'd be nuts. give me the Eagles. So yeah. That's going to do it for this video today. I feel like I rambled on a little bit more in this one. This is going to take me a second to edit. So, let me just get straight to it. And, yeah, hope you guys enjoyed it. Please comment, like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you know when I post a new video. Bye, guys.